Wonga.com is a financial services provider that is based in the Republic of South Africa with an international footprint. The company advertises its services as a loan extension company and has been advertising its services in the country since the beginning of the year 2017. The company promises its customers quick services and low interest rates. However, the company does not seem to have any registered documentation in the country, nor premises, nor staff that it has employed to conduct its services. What it does is that it conducts its business online, advertising that its customers must also put or forward their applications online. We spoke to the Office of the Financial Services Regulatory Authority to find out what prompted them to issue a notice to the effect that members of the public must desist from operating or working with the company. Namiso Njali Njali, who spoke on behalf of the Financial Services Regulatory Authority, had this to say.
It does present a complex nature in that it's an online company wherein consumers may, out of their own volition, continue engaging. But for us, it was to warn those consumers that should anything happen, the FSRA has not been given that opportunity to assess, to fully assess compliance and to fully assess that requirements, licensing requirements have been met by the company. So the legal processes that may follow would be informed by the nature of the company and also where it is domiciled for us to take action on that.
Njali Njali said there is a number of requirements that companies need to follow before they can issue or take monies from customers in the country.
Requirements follows that any financial service provider that wants to engage or transact with consumers in Swaziland, be it on an online platform, be it on any modality that they see fit in terms of their business objectives, they need to apply for a license to be granted authority to offer such services to local consumers. So we do realize that even if it's on an online platform, there are requirements that they have to fulfill. There are steps that they need to take for the regulator to issue such authority. It's regardless of wherever they may be established, the requirements of our legislation follows that we issue a license to a company that is registered under the Companies Act of 2009. So following from that, we would expect that they would establish themselves and form themselves into a Swazi company registered under the laws of the country for us to issue authority for them to operate.
Reporting for Swazi TV, I'm John Perez and Zodwa Dlamini in Mbabane.